Now, you don't have to dig deep to know how remarkable our next guest is. One look at her accomplishments and it hits you right away. This woman is made of steel. But Darlene Berberabe is also compassionate and loving and nurturing and empathetic. Reason why she probably turned her back on what could have been a gainful career as the legal counsel of a multinational corporation to become a public servant. Working for government, she threw herself neck deep into work, rehabilitating and institutionalizing reforms at Pag-ibig Fund, the nation's savings program and shelter fund for the Filipino worker. Darlene, as what her name means, is beloved for the work she's done. Beyond the boardroom, though, when no one's looking, Darlene is still at it. She's just as passionate when she raised her daughter so that when she had to let a Jamie Lim go to pursue her own passions, Darlene understood. When her former partner, basketball superstar Samboy Lim, needed looking after, Darlene was once again there, giving until she had to let him go too. One wonders, did the once young salutatorian of the UP College of Law even imagine that this was the life she was going to lead? Did she even think that she would go full circle and become the dean of the future lawyers of the free? Darlene Berberabe now joins us today, one of the remarkable women we honor this month. Lelen, nice to see you again. Thanks for joining us today.
Well, Carmina, thank you so much for that write-up. Thank you for having me.
All right. Now, with the many things that you had to do from the very beginning, how is it possible that you did not get lost, that you remained true to your core?
Okay. I really just rely on the values that I learned from the family, from the schools that I studied in, from my roots. So I also feel that the values of honor and excellence have been deeply ingrained in me. So also the value for excellence, and I credit that to my parents because they've done a wonderful job brainwashing all the kids. We were still small and they would call us attorney or doctor.
Oh, really?
Yes, because my father was a frustrated lawyer and my mom was a medical doctor. So we were all small, we're five, and three turned out to be lawyers, one a doctor. So they were successful, I would say. So that value of excellence, like if you're a student, then you have to be excellent in it. You have to study well. So whatever role that you get yourself into, you have to be the best. And that was like part of my life and really part of who I am and the work that I do.
So, but when you look at your background, though, Lelen, one would think that you lived a privileged life, daughter of a doctor, and
he was a former mayor,
and a former mayor, correct? And some would think hardship may not have been part of your vocabulary. Is that true?
Well, of course, compared to many, so I would say that we had access to resources that others did not have access to. So, but I really, what I believe is that we maximized the resources that were made available to us, and always the gratefulness is there so that at every step of the way, we are reminded to pay it forward. You have to share, you have to be generous with your talent, and that's why I think, like, even now, I don't need much. So I just need enough to lead a decent and happy life, to provide sufficient for my daughter and for the family. So I don't desire for much wealth, so just enough.
Now, you've met a lot of women throughout your career, and you know this to be true, that women go through a lot, bear a lot, sometimes even more than we could take, right? But for you, what was your biggest difficulty, and how did you rise above it?
Okay, the biggest difficulty, I would say, is the part of the in my personal life, because when you start a family and you raise a family, no one enters a marriage and would want to end up in a broken marriage. And so that part of my life was really difficult because you marry someone that you love and you start a life that you think would be forever. And of course, when the parents also raise a family, you want to be together, or you need for the parents to be together. So, and when the marriage ended, we were focused, Samboy and I were focused on, again, the values of respect, mm-hmm. and we rise above the problem, and we focus on our child, Jamie, and we did that. Mm-hmm. And somehow, Jamie has turned out to be a very good human being, and she's always telling us that she learned the true meaning of unconditional love mm-hmm. from Samboy and myself. So,
but here's the thing, Lelan, and a lot of people don't seem to quite get it. They still marvel at the fact that your greatest heartache, right? It was your greatest heartache, but then you were still able to find the love inside of you to make it your greatest love once again. How did you do that?
Okay, so again, I was just, it didn't take me to like thinking hard about what to do. It just was natural. Okay, so when he had the heart attack in 2014, I was in the hospital, and I thought that, okay, so let me be the one to lead the medical care for Samboy. Because he was a good person, I've come to accept that we just didn't make it to becoming a successful couple, yeah. as a married couple, but I respected him, and I think that he did this. He did have the same respect to me, and that's mm-hmm. why we were able to continue a relationship that is really beyond the normal romantic love that mm-hmm. many couples share. So I'm also very grateful for that opportunity that I got to help him in the time that was the most difficult in his life. So I am filled with gratitude. So many of my friends say that's such a burden. Mm. But for me, I corrected my friend and said, for me, it's a grace. And I am thankful that I'm the one who's able to help him.
Let's focus now, set our sights on you being a lawyer. I mean, you've seen the law come alive, right? From both ends of the spectrum, from a private sector perspective and also from within the public sector. Is it different seeing law come alive from both ends of the spectrum, and how is it different, and should it be different?
Okay, so yes, very different experiences. So, and even in the private sector, also different if you are the CEO or if you are a legal support. So when you are in the private sector, so you just tend to, okay, so what are the laws, what are the regulations? You have to make sure that your company or your client will comply, okay? Mm-hmm. Now, when I went to the public sector as CEO of Pag-ibig Fund, then you are now in a position where you can implement policies. So then you recognize that, okay, when you were in the private sector, you were just complaining, government so slow. And then I was given the opportunity to realize that, okay, so this is how things move, but I will not give up. So those are challenges, and I will try to implement the reforms one day at a time, one program at a time. Mm. And I would like to think that we were able to do that in Pag-ibig Fund. Now in the academe, it's different because in UP Law, so I'm again very grateful for having the experience in all these three sectors. Now in the academe, the focus would be research, public service or extension service, so that the community can take advantage of the research that we do in the academe, and of course to educate our lawyers.
Mm. Well, throughout I think the last decade, Lelan, two phrases have become synonymous with the practice of law here in the country. There's rule of law and there's the weaponization of it. Which one is more real to you?
Okay. So, both are real. So that means that they are they're happening in before our eyes. But now that I'm back in UP Law and in the university, so the rule of law is really important. And we have to remember why law is there. And law is there so that we can have a just society. So the objective of law has to always be remembered, because if not, then you weaponize it. Okay, only the powerful will be able to maintain their interests through law, okay? Through the semblance that, okay, this is what is legal, we've passed laws for this, we're not doing something that is wrong because it is not illegal. But if you are reminded of why the law is there, to administer justice, to provide access to justice by those, especially those that are who are marginalized, mm-hmm. I think that the rule of law will really have meaning to the Filipino people.
Is this a very reason why you accepted the position to be Dean of the UP College of Law? Because Lelen, you could have said no, right? Who needs the headache? But you said yes once again. Why?
Okay, so I always tell my daughter, you know, when other people tell me that, you know, don't go into it because it's hard, I tell my daughter, you know, that's the cue. Get into it. So don't be discouraged by the challenges or the difficulty, because if you believe in yourself and if you know the values, because I know that I'm hardworking, I will pour my time and attention to it, I will study it, and I would like to believe that I really live with honor and excellence. So I want to be able to be in a position where I can help the university implement what we were mandated to do. And so, yes, I said yes to this very great opportunity to serve once again.
Many times in this conversation, you've brought up the name of your daughter, Jamie. We all have different templates, right, in raising empowered women. What is yours? Where did you get it?
Okay. Well, my mom is a strong woman as well. I have a sister, Ate Gigi, who's very close to me, also a strong woman. So we have many role models in the family. And again, I would always tell my daughter, you can have beauty, you can have brains, you can have brawn, but always remember to be a good human being. And to me, if you are born with talent, then you have to be grateful and you have to share it as well. And if you are lacking in something, then you have to train and improve yourself and exert the effort. So I think that, Jamie's accomplishments, I think she has really made a name for herself as well. But most of all, she's kind and generous of her talent and humble like her father. We are very, very proud of her.
And finally, Lelen, women deal with many setbacks, as you know, and you've dealt with several yourself. But what is it about being a woman that makes perseverance sort of second nature to us?
I think also because biologically we bear children, and which is very, very difficult. So there is some a natural quality in women that is nurturing, that is patient, that is willing to put in the work to raise the family, to really raise good children. So I think it's natural for a woman.
Darlene Berberabe there, one of the remarkable women we honor this month. Thank you for being relentless, Lelen.
Thank you also, Carmina.
Nice to see you again.